While bariatric surgery is a very safe surgery, we have data that says that it's actually safer now to have weight loss surgery than to have your gallbladder out. There is always a risk for complications. And so oftentimes my patients want to know, what are the warning signs? Early on, if somebody is beginning to get dehydrated for the first several weeks after surgery, you usually will start to feel a little achy. You might get a little nauseated, and then sometimes you'll feel like you can't get a lot of food down. The main thing to keep you from getting dehydrated is every day working on your liquids. Your goal is to get in about 64 ounces of fluid in a day. If you're not getting in 64 ounces of fluid, you certainly are at risk for getting dehydrated. The next thing is looking at your incisions. When I close your skin, I use staples to bring the skin edges together. It's not uncommon for there to be a little redness around the incisions. This is not typically an infection. What that is just a little irritation from the staples itself. However, if you notice on your incision that it's very red, almost beet red, if it's very warm to the touch or very firm, give my office a call so that we can take a look at your incisions to make sure that they aren't getting infected. The other thing I want you guys to think about is how much walking that you're doing. When you go home, I send everybody home on a blood thinner. Typically, it's going to be oral. However, some insurance companies won't cover the oral medication, so you will need to do an injection every day. Patients that undergo bariatric surgery are at an increased risk for developing blood clots in their legs, and we certainly don't want those to travel up to your lungs. So it's very important that you're moving every day. If you have stairs, go up and down the stairs. If you're in an apartment and you're on the second or third floor, perfect, go up and down the stairs. It's really important that you continue to move, because if not, even when you're on a blood thinner, you're still predisposing yourself to developing blood clots. What are some clues that might make me think that you might be developing a blood clot? If you're short of breath, if you're seeing color changes in your lips. Also, if you notice in your legs that you're having swelling, particularly if you're only having swelling in one leg, and if you're starting to have pain and swelling behind your knee, I certainly want you to give me a call, because that could mean that you're beginning to develop a blood clot. And this is certainly something that we need to address immediately. The other risk that patients can have is development of an infection or a leak inside their abdomen. When you're in the hospital, we always test intraoperatively to make sure that you don't have a leak. And certainly while you're in the hospital, we'll be monitoring your vital signs to make sure that you don't have any warning signs for a possible leak or infection. That the main warning sign that we see would be an elevated heart rate. However, in the hospital, an elevated heart rate could actually be due to a number of things. It could be due to infection. It could be due to a leak. It could be due to a little bit of a drop in your blood levels, but it could also be due to pain that's not being properly controlled or nausea that's not being properly controlled. However, patients need to be aware that every day they should be improving. If you're walking like you should, if you're drinking your fluids like you should, if you're staying on your post-operative diet, every day you should be improving. However, if you're finding that over the course of several days, or certainly over several weeks, that you just don't feel right, you just don't feel well, maybe you have an increased pain in your shoulder, or maybe you just have this increased pain in your upper abdomen, that could mean that there's something else going on in your abdomen, and it's very important that you call the office. Anytime that I have patients that have undergone surgery, I'm always going to be available after hours or on the weekend to take any page. In order to page me, patients need to call my office. My office number is 214-838-7171. If you call that number during the day, my office staff will certainly get in touch with me and let me know what's going on, and I certainly will be getting back to you if it is an emergency. My office staff will also let you know if, whenever you call, if it's an operative day and if I'm operating. Certainly, if there is an emergency, though, my office will definitely reach out to make sure that your message is brought to me and that it's addressed. I really want every one of my patients to do well. Patients have really good outcomes from these surgeries. It is rare that patients have complications, but I want you guys to know that if there is an issue that arises, there's nothing that I can't see you through. I want you to do well. My office staff wants you to do well, and we're here for you every day.